Hi everyone. Traveling for a year was something I didn't really expect to do. I thought maybe I would be gone for a few months at a time. As I was traveling, I managed to make money. I am a copywriter by profession, so that means I was working on things like video scripts and marketing materials. That allowed me to kind of sustain my travels for the whole year that I was gone. I was working like probably at max 10 hours a week. At the beginning of the weeks, I would get my work done before Wednesday as much as I could. And so then I could have time to enjoy Thursday, Friday, and the weekend. And I was really excited to kind of see new places and check different places off my list as fast as I could. By month 5, I started getting pretty burned out. When I think back to it, I was really wearing myself down a lot, and I wasn't giving myself enough time to kind of recover and rest and just really absorb everything that was happening around me. I was kind of just going through the motions, and you know. So it gets really tiresome after a while. Enter Workaway. Basically, it's this online platform where you can apply for different volunteer positions in exchange for accommodation or food. You can like work at a farm, you can help build homes, you can help with childcare, you can teach English to adults. There's so many different types of opportunities available. I mainly only worked at youth hostels. So anyway, I did that in a couple of different places. I would definitely recommend it for anyone who wants to save money, travel long term, and also just get to know a place a bit better. Traveling doesn't have to be expensive. You don't need to spend thousands and thousands of dollars just to see different places around the world. I mean, there are some months that I spent maybe like $3,000, Italy, but in other places, like I think on average it was like $1,000 a month that I was spending. If you want to save money while you're traveling, think about the places that you want to visit. In India, you can find hostels that are like probably like $3 a night if you want to go real cheap, but I would spend a little bit more just because like some places are a little bit seedy. Of course, if you want to travel with a little bit of a higher budget, you can always do Airbnb. It really depends on like what your budget is, what your travel style is, how low maintenance you can make yourself. And yeah, so when I left for my adventure, I guess I was just like in a really bad headspace, and I just remember waking up every morning before going to my job and like literally crying in bed, like not wanting to go at all. And some days I didn't go, some days I just like worked from home, and it felt like really sad and lonely looking back. I never want to get to the point where I'm feeling depressed or lonely or helpless, or that it's at a point where I just feel like there's nothing I can do. You have to do something to change how you're feeling towards yourself and your life, because that's something you can absolutely control. And it's not about having a lot of money, it's not about having connections necessarily, it's just about listening to yourself and what your needs are, and just kind of seeing where it goes. People are going to ask you a lot of questions, like, what are you doing next? Well, what's the point of this trip? They're gonna have all these questions, and you're not gonna know the answers yourself. So giving them some answer is more satisfying than like saying, I don't know, because it's uncertain, it's in the gray zone, and people aren't sure, like, what do I do with, I don't know, you know? My advice to anyone who wants to travel long term, like I did, or you know, do it in your own way, is to just go with it. you don't owe anyone an answer. You don't owe anyone an explanation. You just need to go and see what happens for yourself. Don't need to have it all figured out or know why you're even going, but if you just feel like that's the thing you have to do, then just go. It doesn't have to be super extensive or complicated. And don't put too much pressure on yourself to tell yourself you have to do this and this and follow the book. Berlin, I'm really excited for. I don't know. It's another thing I don't really have a full answer as to why I want to go. It just is like a feeling. I know I want to be living in Europe. I want to be able to travel more and go to different countries. And I think being in the U.S., it's really hard to go and travel abroad. I'm thinking I could do like a moving abroad series and just kind of take you through some updates about how to go about it, maybe more about like the process of moving overseas from an American perspective. I can provide that and give you a firsthand account if you'd like. I think someone else might find it useful. But I'm glad you guys follow along on my journeys, and thanks for supporting me and being interested in my life, which is kind of boring right now. But yeah, I'll see you somewhere in Europe this summer. I don't know where I'm gonna go, but I mean, Berlin, obviously, but I wanna take some trips on there. Anyway, I'll talk to you later.